Hello and welcome to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition. I am Amethyst Lunatari, aka the RPG Chick, and welcome to this video. Anyway, this is not a gameplay video. I'm not even going to be rolling up my character in this video. This is basically just me talking about, well, in order, how I'm going to be playing this game, my plans for the entire series, my experience with Baldur's Gate and Dungeons & Dragons, and what mods I have installed. So, I am going to put timestamps in the video description. Can't do annotations anymore on YouTube, unfortunately. And yeah, basically, I'm going to be talking for a little while about this. I'm going to try not to make it too long, but people are going to complain if I babble on and on in the first video about stuff when they just want to see the game. I just want to give out a big shout out and thanks to Imbacor for his help in putting the logo over the intro sequence that I had created. You can check out his review of Avernum, Escape from the Pit. I'll put a link to that review in the description below. Thanks, Imbacor. In order, my style of gameplay for this let's play, I read everything. I'm going to be reading descriptions. I'm going to be reading dialogue options. Non-voiced, of course. Basically, yeah. Anything and everything that's not voiced and not repeated. I play slow and methodically. I plan to explore every quest, at least appropriate to my character. Every area possible, talk to every character possible. Look at all items, I'm going to be reading item descriptions and such like that, checking things out. My character in general is a very curious, nosy character, so fits right in to my own personality. So if you don't like people who read everything and who play slow and methodically, trying to explore every nook and cranny content possible. Of course, I know I'm going to miss some things, but that won't be, for the most part, that will not be deliberate. But anyway, if you don't like that style of gameplay, then you shouldn't watch this Let's Play. I don't know what else to say. Okay, this LP, I'm labeling them all as blind. So, Let's Play Baldur's Gate EE Blind. Part blah blah blah. But I have played up to a certain point. I'm going to get more into that. I just don't want to name. I just don't want to go from Let's Play Baldur's Gate to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Blind. Just to make things simple. So I'm going to get more into that, why that is such. Oh, no spoilers, please. Since I have not finished this game, or played Baldur's Gate 2 at all, please, no spoilers, and also for the benefit of people watching who may have never played this game. Which I'm sure there'll be at least a few. So no spoilers, no, just no spoilers with spoiler warnings. Just don't put them in there, please. Greatly appreciated. In any case, my plans for the LP. I plan on playing, well, this, and then Siege of Dragonspear expansion, DLC, whatever you want to call it, going right into that after I finish this, and then playing Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition. Of course, I'm playing both of, you know, the entire thing, which includes Shadows of Arm, I believe it's called, and Throne of Baal. And Baldur's Gate 3, I'll be going into after that. So, believe it or not, that was not planned. I've been planning on playing this for quite a while. It's been in the back of my mind for years, but for about a year until my channel got a year or so, my channel got derailed. Otherwise, I would have started this much earlier. But I'm finally in a state where I can play stuff. And I've been wanting to throw in some smaller games here and there, because once I start this, you know, this is a long road. So that's my plans, yeah. Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition, Siege of Dragonspear, Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition, Baldur's Gate 3. Whenever it comes out, which I'm sure it will be out long before I'm ready to play it, before I'm done with Baldur's Gate 2. This LP, at least for now, is me gonna be going up every other day. I may change it to daily at some point, so it's gonna be alternating with Enderal right now. Hold on a second, guys. Alright, I do actually want to make it daily at some point. I'm not sure if I'm going to be doing that with, you know, when I start Siege of Dragonspear, or just somewhere along the line when I finish Enderal, if it's just going to stay like this. I don't know. In any case, we're looking probably about a year like this until I'm done with one of these, maybe. Enderal is a pretty long game as well, so. My experience with Baldur's Gate. I was aware of the game way before I even played it. I played it, I believe it was back, for the first time, back in 2007. And I played up to, but not including, the town of Nashkel. What happened is I was really addicted to clearing out the fog of war, so I kept going back to other areas, fighting, getting in battles which were tough for my level at that point, because I think there's a few that you should handle when you're later in levels, but I kind of wanted to put all that past me and then deal with the Nashkel town and whatever might lie beyond that. So that's why I was stopped there. Well, I pretty much didn't progress any further, and I was going back, you know, going to other encounters, trying to clear everything out, trying different strategies and such, and then I ended up moving. I ended up moving quite far away from where I was, and that whole box was gone. So that was my big box copy of Baldur's Gate, which I believe I had gotten off of eBay. I have another copy now, and plus this is off of GOG.com, so. But yeah, so that's what happened. And then a few years later, I started getting into other games instead, and then always planned on getting back to Baldur's Gate, and then I started my channel, and I started playing games for the channel, and for the most part, except for a few games like Skyrim and Pillars of Eternity, for the most part I was playing shorter games. I knew Baldur's Gate would be long, and I knew I would also be playing Baldur's Gate 2 after it. So I was kind of putting it in the background, and yeah, that's why I am not finishing the game, well, attempting to finish it anyway, as long as nothing horrible happens to me in the next year. That's why I've never finished Baldur's Gate, or played Baldur's Gate 2. I was a player in Dungeons & Dragons Pen & Paper, 2nd edition, and that was a long time ago. And it was a DM for 3rd edition and 3.5. So I'm more familiar with 3rd edition and 3.5, but I am aware, but rusty on 2nd edition, but we're gonna get caught up, believe me. We're gonna break out the WD-40 and we're gonna be playing 2nd edition D&D here. And so, yeah, and all about Thaco and all the rules here and there, most of them anyway. And yeah, so that's why even though it's labeled blind, I know Candlekeep. I know the, was it the Forgotten Arms? Inn? Baraghost, I'm familiar with all that, and plus I've watched people who do, various people do Let's Plays of the game, but not past their arrival at Nashcalc. So, that's that. That's my experience. Excuse me. That's my experience with this. Now, hold on again. Okay, sorry about that, guys. I keep sneezing or almost sneezing. I don't know what's up with that. So, I have installed some mods. The first one I'm going to mention is Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Classic Movies version 2.2.0. What this is, it restores the movies with the original Baldur's Gate, plays them in place of the Beamdog versions. I hate the Beamdog versions. Sorry. For anybody who might enjoy them or thinks they have a certain charm, I do not begrudge you, I don't judge you, anything like that, ending in udge you. But I vastly prefer the original movies. I know they look dated, but to me, I mean, even though I never finished this game, the intro movie and, like, the various movies, Friendly Arms Inn, sorry, that's what I was thinking of. The intro to the Friendly Arms Inn and all that, this is just, it's golden. So, that's why you're watching me play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition, and you're seeing the movies with the old version. So, do not be confused, it's a mod that restores the other movies, cinematics, whatever you want to call it. So the rest of the mods hopefully are any. I know one of them is. What we got here? Lefreut, if I'm saying that right. Enhanced UI. I don't have a version number written down for this one. I'll have to remember to get version. Okay, this is what gives you the UI that you're looking at here. This is not present, at least in the 2.0 era of the game. Enhanced Edition. I think it was 1.3 on, they made a lot of changes. So, and a lot of people do not like the changes, so this, I believe, brings back some of the classic UI elements and elements from 1.3. I could be mistaken. But anyway, to me, it looks great. This is the way I like Baldur's Gate to look. So anyway, more mods. Most of them are quest packs, actually. Baldur's Gate 1 Unfinished Business, version 16.0. Brings in a lot of things missing from the game. Now, I know the Enhanced Edition did add a lot of the original Unfinished Business stuff back into the game, but apparently not all of it, because we still have an Unfinished Business for Enhanced Edition. So, that I've installed. Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition NPC Project, version 23.3. It's a lot of versions. Basically, more lines, interactions for your characters, such like that. Comes highly recommended. Unfinished Business and NPC Project. The rest, well, Chatty Imoen, version 1.3. From what I've heard, Imoen was not added to or put into the game, like, she was late in development. They threw her in. So as a result, she doesn't react to a lot of things or talk to characters the way the others do. At least, so I've heard. I don't even remember. I remember the things Imoen says to you when she, you know, encounters you twice. I remember things she says when she's hurt and stuff like that. But I don't remember anything else Imoen saying. It's just because I haven't played this for 12 years. So it basically adds a lot in. And from what I understand, I'm not completely sure, but I think it adds in voice as well. So I'm not sure if this is newly recorded or stuff they've added back in, which was cut out of the game. But hopefully it sounds like Imoen. That's all I'm going to say. Baldur's Gate. The rest is quests. Yeah, Baldur's Gate mini quests and encounters version 19. This adds a lot of quests. I forget. 8, 10, 12 quests? Something like that? From what I understand, it's not that long. Should take like 30 minutes to play through all of it. Of course, with me, I'm reading everything and I'm like exploring every nook and cranny. It's gonna take me longer. This is probably gonna be the longest Baldur's Gate Let's Play on YouTube. So, yeah, finishing up Ascalon's Quest Pack version 2.05, The Lure of the Sirene's Call version 15, and the Stone of Askavar version 2.1. Those are quest mods. So all quest mods, stuff I'm adding back in. If I'm able to identify which is new stuff and which is quests, I'll probably be able to tell at least with most of it. I'll make a note saying this is not part of the base game or something like that. So that's it. That's all the mods I have installed. So other than that, I mean, I'm just trying to think if there's anything I haven't mentioned, but that's it. That's really it. Oh, and I have my portrait is a Did I throw that out? I think I might have thrown that out, where I have the info for which portrait pack. My character's gonna be a blonde this time, because couldn't find anything that I liked. Yeah, I don't know. It's a quest pack. It's not a quest pack, it's a portrait pack. Yeah, I don't know what I did with it, guys. If I find out, I will put some text down here to say where, what quest pack it's from. But I think I threw that paper out. Unwittingly. So other than that, I'll see you guys in the LP. Oh, also, I understand there are some books in the game which you can read. So I'm already thinking, let's read the books of Baldur's Gate. See you guys in the Let's Play, and always seek adventure.